the ability to dramatize the situations that deserve to be dramatized on the ice.
He throws it down, and in! He scored a goal!
One of the all-time great announcers.
The championship to New Jersey! The Devils win the Stanley Cup!
Shot! Score!
In front, Gianta, and a save made by McDonald on him.
He has really built himself into one of the all-time great announcers. Mike's style is like some of the greats in the past. You know, there's a play developing, and he kind of starts to bring you in.
And the Devils out, man, they might get an odd man rush.
He brings you to this level of a crescendo that only the great announcers can bring.
Feeds it back to Langenbrenner. Oh, a great glove save by McDonald.
He's in a very elite class of guys that understand the ability to dramatize the situations that deserve to be dramatized on the ice.
It's a combination of articulation, speed, accuracy, and humor. And it's a rare blend.
And Witt takes care of his man. And he also must have taken care of the official scorer. He got the assist back.
The enthusiasm that he brings to every game makes you think, well, this is the first game that he's ever done and he's so thrilled about it, or this is the seventh game of the Stanley Cup Finals. It's a rare quality to bring that enthusiasm, and the best part of it is that it's all natural.
What a finesse move by Gervais, and then it is banked back out. That's as good as I've seen since the skills competition.
You could listen to him and you wouldn't even need an analyst, and of course that really says a lot about a play-by-play guy.
In an inexact science, because you're never sure what's going to happen on the ice, he strives for perfection every time he goes to work. So that dedication to perfection every single game, it's always there.
Do I have this, is it 1,500 for Shanahan tonight?
Yes, I believe it is.
1,500 games?
Yeah.
I have to ask him who he skated with in his first game. I know he didn't score a goal in his first game. I do love to prepare. It's fun for me. And occasionally I'll talk to journalism schools and I'll say, you know, you're going to read Western Civilization when you go back to your dorm tonight. I'm going to study about the Bruins and the New Jersey Devils.
This is number 1,500 tonight for him. When he scored his first goal, he was with Andy Brickley and Claude Loisel.
So he played the last two and you played the first 17.
17, yeah.
Grief, I guess you had enough work. And I'm thinking, well, this might be fun to share with people if such and such happens in the game. But you don't bring the game in your briefcase. You kind of have to let the situation dictate whether you use something or not.
Was that old place in Des Moines? Was that?
Yeah, yeah.
Where the locker rooms are side by side?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's still the same one. They renamed it now Buccaneer Arena. That's where the Buccaneers play.
I've been holding on to one thing that I've had for 4 years now because the situation just isn't right for it. Someday you'll hear it.
Over half a dozen times on different teams, including national teams, have Waite and Bill Guerin been on the same line.
And one of his chief assets, which I believe he was the designer originally, was the panels which he uses for every single player on both teams. Tidbits that you could sprinkle throughout the broadcast when it's appropriate.
A pozo from that state that has over 10,000 lakes.
When I first started doing Devils games, the graphics guy came to me and he said, are there three or four things you want to get on? And I said, yeah. So as time passed, I started doing them in advance so he didn't have to come and ask me.
He never forgets his roots. You know, he's from the IHL and the lowest level of hockey. He knows the referees and knows their stories. He knows fans and he knows birthdays and he knows every aspect of the history of the game.
Parise was gently into McDonald at the time it came scorching through.
He will broadcast the game as if he wrote it about 5 hours before. So it's almost as if it's a script, except it's all spontaneous. That, to me, is amazing. And of course, he has created hockey expressions that all the other announcers have picked up on. You know, P. ping-ponging the puck, stuff like that.
Held by Como, thrown in front as it's knifed away from Bailey by Paul Martin.
I had some pretty good teachers coming up through elementary and high school and in college that taught me about words.
Ralston is hunted down and given a lacrosse check from behind by Witt.
But to see it put into practice, I had to rely on Danny Gallivan, the longtime voice of the Canadians, who could make words interesting and entertaining and not make it seem like he was being highbrow.
In school, it was for students like Holik that detention slips were made.
Anybody can come up with a list of four or five words. I'm going to use these tonight. I'm going to call a defenseman truculent. But that doesn't help most people who are watching if they have to run to a dictionary. They're not going to do it.
What a scrum that was.
Like, he can use 20 words in one rush up the ice, and I'm saying, how did he remember and get all that out in one mouthful? And then, of course, bringing all that together and just saying, you know what? These fans want to be entertained, and I'm going to give my best shot to do that.
Cross to Martin for a drive. Save, rebound, score!